Is Nibiru, Planet X, already in our solar system or close to the edge of our solar system? The idea or belief that Nibiru, Planet X, has been around long before the more mainstream scientists hypothesize of Planet 9, Planet X, brought forth just recently. Of course, there are believers and non-believers in Nibiru and Planet X. For various reasons, some are certain of its existence, while understandably, there are those that require much more concrete evidence in order to believe. While both sides cite varying reasons as to why it does or does not exist, there is an overlooked theory that we could share, while some may already be aware of, and many may not be. In random reading and research, the author says here, I've come across some enlightening and very interesting ideas, theories, and possibilities, one of which I have had myself for some time now, ever since I began researching our solar system and its planets more in depth. In fact, we alluded to the idea in an article titled New Study, Planet 9 Likely to Annihilate Our Solar System. So let's get to the theory I have, and some others have as well. Keeping an open mind when you are exposed to this idea that I'm about to present to you, because at first it may be natural reaction to what to want to resist such an idea, especially when we're drilled to believe certain ideas for a long time. And what I'm thinking is that it's quite possible that Jupiter could be Nibiru, this author says. Here's a part of the article, New Study, Planet 9 Likely to Annihilate Our Solar System, that leads some support to the theory I'm proposing. Quote, gas giants are generally found closer to their parent star, aka our sun, and as a matter of fact, our solar system is highly unusual in that our gas giants are all in the outer region of our solar system and not in the inner orbits, likely they typically are found to be in other systems. I never even knew that. That's news to me. In other systems, these gas giants are closer to the sun. In ours, they're in the outer solar system. So it's a scientific fact that it is highly unusual for the larger planets to be in the outer part of their planetary system, or in other words, in their solar system. Kindly support my Patreon account. The daily posts are 5 videos daily, and they are totally different from what I have on my YouTube channel. Thank you so much for your support and that you find all my content so interesting. You'll find the Patreon account details in the description box. Now, that's an unusual thing. In addition, Jupiter, the fifth planet from the sun, gas giant and subject to the Juno mission, is huge, and Jupiter is huge. It's so huge, in fact, that it does not actually orbit the sun, not exactly. With 2.5 times the mass of all the other planets in the solar system combined, it's big enough that the center of gravity between Jupiter and the sun does not actually reside inside the sun, rather at the point in space just above the sun's surface. Gas giant type planets are not usually found in the outer part of their solar system, yet Jupiter is in the outer orbit of our solar system. The Sumerians called Jupiter Nibiru or Neberu. So Jupiter was called Neberu by the Sumerians. That's news to me.
This is 3 years, like the good Lord said. destroy the temple, and I will raise it again in 3 years. We're at that time where the children of the Waco will be heard. We've been a sacred society for 25 years now. Now it's time for people to know what we've been keeping secret. It's that great and dreadful day of the Lord. As I mentioned earlier, you know, that they're turning the clocks back up tonight.
10 seconds.
Thank you very much. 10 seconds. And this is the 9th time they've done that. And they're doing that because the planet is out of alignment. The planet is slowing up. As you know, the mirror is already in place. The countdown for 2000 is in. The world is in uproar.
There is no such thing as Planet Nimburu or whatever they say. It's just fiction. And they cite sources that cite NASA sources. They don't cite NASA. Check the websites, you'll see. And it's all related to the doomsday predictions of the year 2012. Yes, that's what you're getting at. That's behind your question, isn't it? Yes. 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 You want to know if the world is going to end on December 21st, 2012. Because the same website that tells you about Planet X, this secret planet that will has a strongly elliptical orbit that will come into our zone in 2012 and knock Earth off its axis, combined with, on December 21st, 2012, that the center of the galaxy, the Sun and the Earth, will come into perfect alignment, and the excess gravity will then also tip Earth off its axis, and it'll be end of the world as we know it. This is what these web pages will tell you. Turns out, if you go to December 21st and look at the star charts, it's true. The center of the galaxy, the Sun and the Earth, will come into perfect alignment. It will. It's true. It's true. What the site does not tell you is that that happens every year on December 21st. They left that out of the account. So it's a fun work of fiction. Earth will be here before, during, and after 2012. I will add that the movie 2012 that's being marketed right now, that's going to come out in 2012, and they want you to do all the homework for the movie, so they say, just Google it. And if you Google 2012, it's filled with thousands of web pages on doomsday, written by people who didn't take enough science in school. So you Google it. I saw some of the previews for it, and I was worried that we would, you know, all of us in this business would just be inundated with having to sort of correct misconceptions. And then I saw what they actually show in the movie. And the movie's like, aliens come, and they take over the Capitol. And I said, oh, that's just another sort of, like the movie Independence Day, and that's fine. It's just Hollywood.